Daily Evening Prayer, Tuesday, December 19th, 2023. Let us stay awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come, in the evening or at midnight, or when the rooster crows, or in the morning. They seek him suddenly and find you asleep. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, thou art and stray from your ways of lost sheep. We have followed too much of the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy law. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done things which we ought not to have done. Apart from your grace, there is no hope in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. With us, your faults. Bestow the penitent according to your promises, affect all people in Christ Jesus. And grant, O most merciful Father, for the sake that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life to the glory of your holy name. Grant your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, our mouth shall proclaim and praise. God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun, and our eyes behold the visible light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of God, and to be glorified through all. We'll sing unto the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. With his own right hand and with his holy arm, he has sworn for himself the victory. The Lord declared his salvation, his righteousness, as he openly shown to them in the sight of the nation. He has remembered his mercy and truth toward the house of Israel, that all the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Show yourselves joyful in the Lord, O you lands. Sing, rejoicing, give thanks. Praise the Lord with the harp. Sing with the harp a song of thanksgiving. With trumpets also and horns, show yourselves joyful before the Lord, the King. Let the sea make a noise and all that is in it, the round world and those who dwell therein. Let the rivers clap their hands and let the hills be joyful together before the Lord, for he has come to judge the earth. With righteousness shall he judge the world, and the peoples with equity. The Lord is King, let the peoples tremble. He sits between the cherubim, let the earth shake. The Lord is great in Zion, and high above all peoples. They shall give thanks unto his name, which is great and wonderful. Holy is he and mighty, a king who loves justice. You have established equity, you have executed judgment and righteousness in Jacob. O magnify the Lord our God and fall down before his footstool, for he is holy. Moses and Aaron among his priests, and Samuel among those who call upon his name. They called upon the Lord and he heard them. He spoke to them out of the cloudy pillar, for they kept his testimonies and the law that he gave them. You heard them, O Lord God, you forgave them, O God. Yet punish their evil doings. O magnify the Lord our God and worship him upon his holy hill, for the Lord our God is holy. O be joyful in the Lord, O you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness and come before his presence with a song. Be assured that the Lord, he is God, it is he that has made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. I'll go your way into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and speak good of his name. For the Lord is gracious, and his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth from generation to generation. My song shall be of mercy and judgment unto you, O Lord, will I sing. O let me have understanding in the way of godliness. When will you come to me? I will walk in my house with integrity of heart. I will set no wicked thing before my eyes. I hate the sins of unfaithfulness. No such thing shall be to me. A crooked heart shall depart from me. I will not know a wicked person. Whoever secretly slanders his neighbor, him will I destroy. Whoever has a proud look and an arrogant heart, I will not suffer him. My eyes shall look with favor upon the faithful in the land, that they may dwell with me. Whoever leads a godly life, he shall be my servant. No deceitful person shall dwell in my house. The one who tells lies shall not tarry in my sight. I shall soon destroy all the ungodly who are in the land, that I may root out all evildoers from the city of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. Amen. A reading from the prophet Isaiah, beginning with the 62nd chapter, the first verse. For Zion's sake, I will not keep silent, and for Jerusalem's sake, I will not keep quiet, until her righteousness goes forth like brightness, and her salvation like a torch that is burning. The nations will see your righteousness, and all kings your glory, and you will be called by a new name which the mouth of the Lord will designate. You will also be a crown of beauty in the hand of the Lord, and a royal headband in the hand of your God. It will no longer be said to you, forsaken, nor to your land will it any longer be said desolate, but you will be called, my delight is in her, and your land, Mary. For the Lord delights in you, and to him your land will be Mary. For as a young man marries a virgin, so your sons will marry you. And as the groom rejoices over the bride, so your God will rejoice over you. On your walls, Jerusalem, I have appointed watchmen all day and all night. They will never keep silent. You who profess the Lord, take no rest for yourself, and give him no rest until he establishes and makes Jerusalem an object of praise on the earth. The Lord has sworn by his right hand and by his mighty arm, I will never again give your grain as food for your enemies, nor will foreigners drink your new wine for which you have labor, but those who harvest it will eat it and praise the Lord, and those who gather it will drink it in the courtyards of my sanctuary. Go through the gates, clear a way for the people, build up the highway, remove the stones, lift up a flag over the peoples. Behold, the Lord has proclaimed to the end of the earth. Say to the daughter of Zion, behold, your salvation is coming. Behold, his reward is with him, and his compensation before him, and they will call them the holy people, the redeemed of the Lord, and you will be called sought out, a city not abandoned. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Seek the Lord while he wills to be found. Call upon him when he draws near. Let the wicked forsake their ways and the evil ones their thoughts. Then let them turn to the Lord, and he will have compassion, and to our God, for he will richly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your. So are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as rain and snow fall from the heavens and return not again, but water the earth, bringing forth life and giving growth, seed for sowing, bread for eating, so is my word that goes forth from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, But it will accomplish that which I have purposed and prosper in that for which I sent it. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke, beginning with the 19th chapter, the 11th verse. Now, when they were listening to these things, Jesus went on to tell a parable, because he was near Jerusalem, and they thought that the kingdom of God was going to appear immediately. So he said, A nobleman went to a distant country to receive a kingdom for himself, and then to return. And he called 10 of his own slaves and gave them 10 minas, and said to them, Do business with this money until I come back. But his citizens hated him and sent a delegation after him, saying, We do not want this man to reign over us. When he returned after receiving the kingdom, he ordered that the slaves to whom he had given the money be summoned to him, so that he would learn how much they had made by the business they had done. The first slave appeared, saying, Master, your mina has made 10 minas more. And he said to him, Well done, good slave. Since you have been faithful in a very little thing, you are to have authority over 10 cities. The second one came, saying, Your mina, master, has made 5 minas. And he said to him, Also, you are to be over 5 cities. And then another came, saying, Master, here is your mina, which I kept tucked away in a handkerchief, for I was afraid of you, because you are a demanding man. You take up what you did not lay down, and reap what you did not sow. He said to him, From your own lips I will judge you, you worthless slave. Did you know that I am a demanding man, taking up what I did not lay down, and reaping what I did not sow? And why so did you not put my money in the bank, and when I came back I would have collected it with interest? And when he said to the other slaves who were present, and then he said to the other slaves who were present, Take the mina away from him and give it to the one who has the 10 minas. And they said to him, Master, he already has 10 minas. I tell you that to everyone who has, more shall be given, but from the one who does not have, even what he does have shall be taken away. But as for these enemies of mine, who did not want me to reign over them, bring them here and slaughter them in my presence. After Jesus said these things, he was going on ahead, going up to his son. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. O key of David and scepter of the house of Israel, who opens and no man shuts, who shuts and no man opens, come and lead forth the captive who sits in the shadows from his prison. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. But behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed, for he that is mighty has magnified me, holy is his name, and his mercy is on those who fear him throughout all generations. He has shown the strength of his arm, he has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones, and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent and people away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel, as he promised to our fathers Abraham and Steve forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O King of David, scepter of the house of Israel, who opens and no man shuts, who shuts and no man opens. Come and lead forth the captive who sits in the shadows from his prison. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, O Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the fifth day he rose again, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God. He Who can begin to judge the living and the dead? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. This evening may be holy, good, and peaceful. We entreat you, O Lord. That your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill. We entreat you, O Lord. That there may be pardon, that we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses. We entreat you, O Lord. That there may be peace in your church and in the whole world. We entreat you, O Lord, that we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ. We entreat you, O Lord. O Lord Jesus Christ, you sent your messengers to prophets to preach repentance and prepare the way for our salvation. Grant that the ministers and stewards of your mysteries may likewise make ready your way by turning the hearts of the disobedient toward the wisdom of the just, that at your second coming to judge the world, we may be found a people acceptable in your sight. For with the Father and the Holy Spirit, you reign, you live and reign, one God, now and forever. Lighten our darkness with the seed here, O Lord, and by your great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. O God, you manifest in your sons the signs of your presence. Send forth upon us the spirit of love, that in companionship with one another, your abounding grace may increase among us through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercy, we, your unworthy sons, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of praise and glory. That we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercy, that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives. By giving up ourselves to your service, but by walking before you in holiness and righteousness of our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to help with you and the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory throughout all ages. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son, that once we will be gathered together in his name, you will grant them Christ. Until now, O Lord, our desires and petitions, as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth. And in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to God, with power working in us, can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to Him from generation to generation, and the Church, in Christ Jesus, ever and ever. Amen.